What's up, guys? It's Matilda, obviously, and you know that because you're on my channel. And today I thought that I would react to Big Mouth. It's like a TV show on Netflix, I believe, and in that show there's one trans character, so I thought that I would react to it. And I have actually seen other YouTubers react to this show. I haven't seen what they have reacted to. I haven't seen anything of this show, so it's going to be like a first time reaction. And I think I kind of have to address my new hair. Yes, I'm brunette again. That was just something I wanted to address. You know, look at my new hair. I was actually blonde for like 4 years, but I'm naturally brunette, as many of you know. So I'm back to my roots. Yes. But anyways, let's get into this video. And before we get into this video, don't forget to follow me on my Instagram. You know, fun time. Fun time. And also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. It's down below. You know, click it. It's down below. Yeah. I actually have a major goal in 2021 to reach 100k. So you would really help the girly out by click that subscribe button. And also, don't forget to like, comment, and everything like that. That really helps me a lot. But now, let's get into this video. I'm going to react to it on my phone, and you're going to see it here on the screen as usual, and let's just get into it. And I just want to let you know that I'm going to react to 3 clips, so yeah, let's just get into it, shall we? So here's the first one.
Hey guys, this is Natalie. She'll be in our bunk this summer. She is trans, so everybody just be cool.
Why did she have to tell them that? Like, that's so awkward. Why did she out her? Why did that girl out Natalie? Please don't do this. If you know that someone is trans and you're in the new setting, please don't out them. That's kind of rude and disrespectful. But yeah, let's keep on watching.
Wait, Gabe?
It's Natalie, actually.
That is so cool.
Love her dolphin. That's cute. That's really cute. We'd love to have one of those.
Yes, queen. Go off, girl boss.
Yeah, I kind of love how supportive they are. They accept her like immediately. Respect.
This bunk is already way better. The boys were such scroats.
Scroats? Ew. What is that? What are you saying? Don't talk like that.
Oh, sorry. Apologize.
Now that
sounds like a girl.
What kind of girl is this?
Okay, so this is a very common reaction or like behavior that some people have towards trans people. They kind of try to gatekeep how it is being a girl or like how you should behave as a girl. I've actually had so many people in my life try to gatekeep and try to like tell me how I should behave. Don't sit like that. Don't talk like that. Girls are not supposed to act like that. And now they're also asking her what kind of girl she is. I mean, they are really fixating on the fact that she's trans. Please be kind of chill. When you realize that someone is trans, just don't be too nosy and ask too many questions, because being trans is hard as it is. Too many questions can be very uncomfortable. However, I need to highlight the fact that they were actually gendering her correctly. So, you know, a little applaud for that. That's great. You know, that's respect. I need to, you know, kind of gotta highlight that. That's good.
I see Hari Nef, Fashion Week, Gucci. I see snakes everywhere.
No, snakes are phallic and that's offensive. We need something inclusive. Ooh, with dreadlocks, full geisha, in a wheelchair.
What if we just went classic? Caitlyn Jenner, silk bustier, mega hat braid.
No.
Yes, like what trans people need. A Make America Great Again hat, like. And also, honestly, there are other trans people than Caitlyn Jenner. Yeah, they are acting very rude. Like, please don't do this. If you ever meet a trans person, please don't ever act like this. The rudeness is surreal.
What's your problem?
You know what? I'm just gonna wear my own clothes.
No offense, and not to be a... but your current look is pretty butch.
Yeah, don't you wanna, like, pass as a girl or whatever?
Excuse me?
They are disrespectful. Please don't just like, get out of my face, get out of my face. Honestly, just get out of Natalie's face. They are so rude right now. Okay, so that was the first clip. And some ways, it was kinda a good reaction. I mean, they were gendering her correctly as soon as they met her. However, they were kind of gatekeeping how a girl is supposed to act. Not so great. But let's move on to the second clip for today.
Hey.
Good opening.
Are you here to tell me I'm butch or ask me what my crotch looks like?
I just
wanted to say coming back to camp seems really hard.
Yeah.
So did you, like, already know last summer?
That I was a girl?
Yeah.
Kinda. I mean, this is gonna sound weird, but when I started going through puberty, it was like this monster showed up.
All right, buddy. We're gonna give you broad, hairy shoulders and a high ass. Oh, and you're gonna get more than a no-kill animal shelter.
No! Get away from...
Yeah, I can really relate to this. I remember before I transitioned, when I started to go through my puberty, and I was just like, my gender dysphoria was really starting to act up, and I was so desperate in stopping what the puberty started to change. I was just feeling miserable, and yeah, I can really relate to it feeling like a monster showed up and was just like trying to change me in ways that I was just like, nope. I'm a girl, stop. It was horrible. I started to talk to a therapist and then they helped me to get on HRT, the hormone replacement therapy. So yeah. Also, I kind of have to address, she said, are you going to tell me that I'm butch or how my crotch looks like? They asked too many questions and obviously Natalie was offended, and that is not really hard to understand because they were not really nice to her. People don't go around asking people what's between their legs, but when it comes to trans people, a lot of cisgender people think that that's acceptable and it's not. You shouldn't do that. I mean, if you're not in a relationship with them or if you're not dating them, please don't ask them what's between their legs. But yeah, let's move on.
I think maybe I'm gay.
Yeah, yes. I did kind of think you were gay.
So did I, and I realized that didn't feel right either. It was something more than that.
What's your f***ing problem, kid?
I don't know. I just know I hate you and what you're doing to my body.
Nobody likes puberty.
It was like... I was vibrating at this weird frequency all the time. But then I found this forum for trans kids, and it was like, that's who I am. So I told my parents. So we decided I should go on hormone blockers.
All right, let's get you some toe hair.
Okay, so Natalie, our girly, got herself a friend, so that's nice. But let's move on to the third and final clip for this video.
I just checked out Milk's ass.
If you look at it by itself, it's actually kind of good.
Like, yeah, that boy got cake.
Hey, Natalie. Hi. Did you,
nice outfit.
Did you hear about that the bird in the woods? It's been swelling up all summer, and I actually think it's gonna pop tonight.
Oh my God, so romantic. Like, he gave her a bird. That's so sweet. Romantic.
Wow. Very cool.
Remember I hawked that red loogie last year? It's kind of near there.
Yeah, we remember. You keep bringing it up.
Just like I brought up that red loogie. Anyway, you want to go see the bird, baby? Yeah, I want. Tell me, let me know.
Oh my God, he's so into you.
What? Shut up! Wait, why? What makes you think that?
Yeah. Look at him. That's his sad attempt at flirting.
Oh my God, like honestly, this reminds me when you're like walking down the street and a bunch of guys drive past you on motorcycles and they go like brum 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 and you're like, yeah, you can drive a motorcycle, that's great, congratulations. Like, which girl in history has ever been like, oh my God, he f***ed my eardrums, I have fallen in love, like I really want to meet him, he's my perfect dream. Which girl? Please tell me. Like, if you ever meet her, you won't, but if you ever meet her, give me a call, okay?
You should go see the bird with him.
Yeah, but this would be my first time, like, kissing a boy, and it just feels scary.
Wow, that is certainly a bird.
Crazy how tall these trees are.
So tall.
So tall.
Super.
Yeah.
So what else should we do?
I don't know.
Are we moving closer to each other?
You're not turning away from me. Turning away from you.
Yep.
Thank you for doing what's about to happen.
So, should we go back to the group?
The group? Oh, yeah, totally. How do we want to do this? Do you, want to go first and I'll just hang back and chill for a sec?
What?
Or do you want me to run as fast as I can and then you just show up later?
What do you mean?
I'm just saying, I don't know if we should show up at the same time because then, you know, everyone will know.
Oh my God. You don't want anyone to know.
I'm just mildly terrified of what the guys will say because you're...
I'm what? Say it. I'm trans.
Okay, so he knew that she was trans. However, he's not really comfortable with other people knowing that they are together or they're not together, but you know, what they just did. So he's into her, but he doesn't want other people to know. And honestly, a lot of straight guys is acting like this. They're too scared of people knowing that they're actually into or likes a trans girl. And honestly, I mean, a lot of people get hate. I mean, especially trans people get hate for being trans. So I understand that they're scared of getting hate themselves. But honestly, if you're not brave enough to scream at the top of your lungs that you like this girl, you shouldn't lead her on. Because it's not nice. It's not nice to tell someone that you like them, however you don't like them enough to tell other people that you like them. Like, just don't act on your feelings at all. Because, like, that's not nice. It's not nice, okay? And also, he's not even that cute. Just saying.
I mean, yes, but no, it's because you are so great, and they'll get jealous.
You, I'm a person, not something to hide. This is such a bummer.
Natalie, I'm sorry!
Yeah, so I kind of deserve that. Being trans is really hard sometimes, and this show, I mean, they really show the viewers what it's like being trans, and honestly, I love that. They did me proud, they did me good, because honestly, it's really important being represented correctly in media, because it can affect how people perceive you. Presentation in media is obviously important, so this show did it good. They did it great, I'm happy. But if you like this video, please give it a like, comment, subscribe, and also the little bell icon to get future notifications whenever I post. And thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.